Local webcasting for a worldwide audience.
Hi, Nick and Hannah McMaster of Brighton-based folk gaze band Dateless Wonder Club, back with Finding Land Folk Show, music from the shores of folk, here on Radio Lewes, where music matters. Welcome.
Hannah.
Nick.
Episode 20.
Ooh, we should have like some party poppers or something like that.
Well, that's the 21st episode though, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, true.
But 20.
Oh, I know. It's been a blast so far.
Amazing. Let's do a celebratory 21st episode,
Absolutely.
Though.
Absolutely.
Whether you are steeped in the genre like me, a toe dipper like Hannah...
Can you classify them strictly as toes, Nick?
A hoof dipper like Hannah, or joining the journey for the first time, we are delighted that you can join us for an hour, a bit more, or so, quite a bit more, of traditional and contemporary folk and folk-adjacent music from around the UK and beyond, with a healthy sprinkling of artists from our own beautiful part of the world in Sussex. We won't be druv, Hannah.
We won't be druv, Nick. We start today's show with a track from the 2023 compilation album Ears of the People, Ekonting songs from Senegal and the Gambia on the Smithsonian Folkways record label. The Ekonting is a three-stringed gourd lute played by Djola people in Gambia and the Casamance region of Senegal. The artists featured on the album share stories of love, heartache, conflict and spirituality and include this song by 71-year-old Abdoulaye Diallo, whose songs move between personal and political storytelling. Every song has a significance, he says. There is the song, but then there is the story behind the song. Loosely translated as Come In Mother, this is Inje, Mama, Oomei.
Inje, Mama, Oomei, Inje, Mama, Jukotol. Inje, Mama, Oomei. Inje ayo jukotol, inje mama Oomei. Oh, kenje bejata, inje mama jukotol, mama jaya oye.
Travelling due east away from Senegal to the other side of the African continent, we find the music of Sudanese-Italian singer Amira Kirj, who has been described as the diva of the Sudanese desert by BBC World News.
Nick,
mm-hmm.
If I was a diva of anywhere, where would it be?
Aldi. From her 2011 album, View From Somewhere, on the Contro Cultura music record label, this is... Alleluia.
Yeah.
On to a regular feature of the show. Oh, I'm excited. It's Hannah's Could It Be Folk?
Nope.
Where I present one of my favourite songs and ask Nick, rather hopelessly, I suppose, could it be folk? In front of the hanging judge today.
Oops, sorry, Hannah, I'll do my zip up.
Unbelievable. Is You Made Me the Thief of Your Heart, a song by the unmistakable voice of Sinead O'Connor, from the soundtrack to the 1993 Jim Sheridan film, In the Name of the Father.
Hannah?
Nick?
Do you think it would have been better if Des O'Connor had sung it? Dum dum, dicka dum dum.
I would have liked to have heard that.
Thief of your heart.
rise.
I'm standing, apprehensively waiting.
So, Hannah, thank you for your choice.
You're welcome.
It appears the old dog might be trying to learn a new trick.
Who are you calling a dog?
But before I make my summary, let us again remind our listeners, this is your favourite part, what our chief constituent parts are for a good folk song.
Your, not our. Traditional instruments and a good story, which in your view is best when it's about death.
So I think we can say, aside from the drums and piano, there are fiddles.
Oh, there are fiddles.
Some harp, and maybe even an accordion. Definitely a flute. And I think even some spoons, if my hearing is not playing games, which emphasise the Celtic influences, maybe not the spoons part, from a song part penned by U2's Bono, a well-known spoons player.
Absolutely.
And from a singer who has dabbled in folk rock. The vocal does nod a little towards the folk genre.
A rare concession there.
Hmm. So far, so good, Hannah. Well done.
Ah, thank you, thank you, thank you. I'm wising up.
But don't prepare your victory speech on the courthouse steps yet. We have to look at the case against. The song has its strongest folk elements at the beginning, where we have a folk rock intro, and at the end, where we have the vigorous fiddle playing.
Oh, I love a vigorous fiddle, Nick.
Better keep my zip up. But the fast part of the song has an almost trip-hop feel, as if Massive Attack had taken over Clannad.
Oh, now that's a fusion I'd love to see.
Let's just say, though, this is a brilliantly powerful song with possibly O'Connor's best vocal since Nothing Compares to You.
Mm.
However, the way the song is constructed, and especially the large middle section, moves it towards electronic music with Celtic influences rather than the other way round. Whilst we have played electronic folk music by the likes of Fiona Sopang and Stick in the Wheel, there are much clearer folk sensibilities within their works, such as vocal delivery, lyrical content, or the way the traditional elements still dictate the presentation.
Really, Nick, it's you that dictates, isn't it, the what's folk or not?
So, Hannah, could it be folk? I don't know. This feels like electronic music with added additions in the same way as Enigma's 1990 number one smash hit, Sadness Part 1, had Gregorian chanting. Memorable, but maybe not absolutely integral.
Oh, that's a good song as well.
You could not say that about the electronic elements. So my decision is no. But spare the noose, send her down, but not for the full stretch.
Oh, well, wait till you hear my next choice, Nick. I've got one rumbling in the barrels waiting for you.
Rumbling in the barrels?
Yeah, I just made that up.
Okay, good, 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 good.
Thank you.
after yet another failed attempt for me at finding land with Sinead O'Connor and her song You Made Me the Thief of Your Heart, you've just heard Bat for Lashes, Horse and I, from her 2006 album Fur and Gold on Parlophone Records. It's a great album, that.
Mm-hmm.
Here, Natasha Khan, who performs as Bat for Lashes, shows the way by creating a song that has electronic soundtrack feel but allows the traditional elements to hold their own.
Hannah?
Nick?
Is it now time for me to pull out my top bat facts that I've been waiting to do for quite a while?
Well, hell yes. Do you always just have them just in case bats get bought up?
So, there are over 1,400 species of bats worldwide. The difference in size and shape are equally impressive. Bats range in size from the kitty hog-nosed bat that weighs less than a penny, making it the world's smallest mammal, to the flying foxes, which can have a wingspan of up to 6 feet.
Wow.
Without bats, say goodbye to bananas, avocados and mangoes.
Oh.
Over 300 species of fruit depend on bats for pollination.
Wow.
Bats help spread seeds for nuts, figs and cacao, the main ingredient of chocolate.
Mmm.
Hannah.
Nick.
Bats may be small, but they're fast little creatures.
They are.
They can reach speeds of over 100 miles per hour.
Wow.
That must mean they're very mobile. Bat-mobile. Yep.
Unbelievable. That might be the worst joke you've ever told.
The longest living bat is 41 years old.
Oh, that's just a little bit younger than me.
That's who I was referring to. Now, I know the normal facts I bring in are related to music.
Yes.
The Aquabats are an American rock band formed in Huntington Beach, California in 1994. Kiwi pastoral jangle pop band The Bats have been going since the early 80s and are an institution on the New Zealand music scene.
Oh.
The Fruit Bats are the indie rock act that started as a recording project of Chicagoan Eric D. Johnson, who we've previously played on the show.
Uh-huh.
And finally, there is Cancer Bats, a Canadian hardcore punk band from Toronto, Ontario. But do not worry, Cancer Bats, because bats are inspiring medical marvels. About 80 medicines come from plants that rely on bats for their survival.
Wow. Wow, Nick. I mean, you truly enriched my life with all your bat knowledge.
If I truly enrich your life through my bat knowledge, it just shows what an insipid, pathetic person you are.
or how little you bring to my life.
Let's play some music. We'll be right back.
listening to Finding Land Folk Show on Radio Lewes. We are supported by our friends at promoters Melting Vinyl and the Foghorn Micropub in Port Slade. Whether you are a folk musician with a song to share or a listener with a song to suggest, please drop us a line at findinglandfolkshow@gmail.com. For those of you with love in your heart and spare cash in your pocket, you can also help with production of the show by searching for Finding Land Folk Show, Buy Me a Coffee, and follow the links.
Following on from Bat for Lashes, Horse and I, we've just heard progressive Celtic rock band Horselips with High Reel, and Tennessee-founded roots music band Real Time Travellers with Little Bird of Heaven. Founded in Dublin in 1970 and inspired by early Genesis and Jethro Tull.
Well, who isn't?
Horselips were at the centre of the folk rock boom of the mid-1970s and were compared favourably with such English electric folk acts as Steel Eye Span.
When I was younger, I always used to confuse Steel Eye Span and Steely Dan. I used to kind of think they were the same band. And I'm ashamed to say, when I say when I was younger, I'm not talking like when I was like eight, and probably when I was in my early 20s.
With whom they toured. From their 2019 album, Established 1969.
Like you.
Absolutely. On Park Records are London's Steel Eye Span, with the inimitable Maddie Pryor on vocals and January Man.
Not Steel Eye Dan. Not Steely Dan.
Unbelievable.
I'm still getting them all confused.
January man, he walks the road in woolen coat and boots of leather. The February man still shakes the snow from off his head and blows his hands. The man of March, he sees the spring and wonders what the year will bring and hopes for better weather. April rain, the man goes down to watch the birds come in to share the summer. The man of May stands very still, watching the children dance away the day. In June, the man inside, the man is young and wants to lend a hand and grins at each newcomer.
busy road he knows so well. The January man is here, starting each and every year. Along the road forever.
Just before Steel I Span, we heard Little Bird of Heaven by Real Time Travellers. In 2002, the song placed first in the bluegrass category in the prestigious Chris Austin Songwriting Contest at Melfest. Judges included folk singer-songwriter Gillian Welch, who has appeared on several soundtracks, including that for the critically acclaimed Coen Brothers 2000 film, O Brother, Where Art Thou? Which is a great film. I love that film.
Mm-hmm.
And the soundtrack, which showcases a spectrum of musical styles typical of the old culture of the American South. Founded in 1988 in Wilkesboro, North Carolina, in memory of the late Eddie Merle Watson, son of American music legend Doc Watson, Melfest is considered one of the premier traditional and roots music festivals in the country. To celebrate Melfest, which is held in April, we first have Gillian Welch with Scarlet Town, the lead song from her 2011 album, The Harrow and the Harvest, on Akoni Records.
I seen in sky.
feeling bad. Bad luck's all I've ever had. Going down this road feeling bad, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. Got me way down in jail on my knees. This old jailer, he sure is hard to please. Feed me on cornbread and peas, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. How do you feel about it, Merle? Sweet mama won't buy me no shoes. Lord, she's left me with these lonesome jailhouse blues. My sweet mama won't buy me no shoes, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. And these $2 shoes, they hurt my feet. The jailer won't give me enough to eat. Lord, these $2 shoes, they hurt my feet, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna. Suits my clothes. Lord, I'm going where these chilly winds never blow. I'm going where the climate suits my clothes, Lord, Lord, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. Yes, I'm going down this road feeling bad, Lord, 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 I'm going down this road feeling bad. Bad luck's all I've ever had, it sure is, and I ain't gonna be treated this way. Pick it one time.
From their 2002 album Elementary, Dr. Watson, that was the traditional American folk song Going Down the Road Feeling Bad by Doc and Merle Watson. Described as a white blues of universal appeal and uncertain origin, much like me, the song has been recorded by, amongst others, Woody Guthrie, The Grateful Dead and Bob Dylan. Here is the legendary singer-songwriter Bob Dylan with a song inspired by Guthrie. From his third album, 1963's The Times They Are A-Changing, this is North Country Blues.
Unbelievable.
Come and gather round, friends, and I'll tell you a tale of when the red iron armpits run aplenty, put the cardboard filled windows and old men on the benches. Tell you now that the whole town is empty. In the north end of town, my own children have grown. Well, I was raised on the other, in the wee hours of youth, my mother took sick, and I was brought up by my brother. The iron ore poured as the years passed the door. The drag lines and the shovels, he was humming, till one day my brother failed to come home. The same as my father before him. With a long winter's wait from the window, I watched. My friends, they couldn't have been kinder, and my school it was cut as I quit in the spring to marry John Thomas, a miner. All the years passed again and the giving was good. with a lunch bucket filled every season. But with three babies born, the work was cut down to a half a day shift with no reason. Then the shaft was soon shut and my work was cut, and the fire in the air, it felt frozen. Till a man come to speak, and he said in 1 week that number 11 was closing. They complain in the east, they're paying too high. They say that your ore ain't worth digging, that it's much cheaper down in the South American towns, where the miners work almost for nothing. So the mining gates locked and the red iron rotted, and the room smelled heavy from drinking. And the sad silent song made the hour twice as long as I waited for the sun to go sinking. I lived by the window as he talked to himself. This silence of tongues it was building till one morning's wake the bed it was bare, and I was left alone with three children. The summer is gone, the ground's turning cold, the stars one by one they're folded. My children will go as soon as they grow, for there ain't nothing here now to hold them.
Legendary singer-songwriter Bob Dylan was born Robert Alan Zimmerman in St. Mary's Hospital on May 24, 1941, in Duluth, Minnesota, which is home to indie rock band Low, formed in 1993 by Alan Sparhawk, guitar and vocals, and Mimi Parker, drums and vocals, whose most distinctive element are their often country-tinged vocals and harmonies. Sadly, Parker died of ovarian cancer in November 2022, aged only 55. From their 2013 Sub Pop Records album, The Invisible Way, this is Low and Holy Ghost.
Some Holy Ghost keeps me hanging on. Me hanging on. my passion for transcendence, turns my water into wine, makes me wish I was empty. Now I don't tell when something's wrong, and something's wrong, but some Holy Ghost keeps me.
I cry for mercy.
That was Nicole by Gravenhurst, the pseudonym of singer, multi-instrumentalist and freelance journalist Nick Talbot, who died in 2014 at the tender age of 37. An instrumental version of Nicole featured on the soundtrack to Shane Meadows' 2006 critically acclaimed British drama This Is England. I thought I recognised the music.
Okay.
I did. I just thought it was music written for the film. I didn't realise it was a whole full song. So that was nice to discover.
Good.
What a beautiful song. It's a beautiful, I think that's a beautiful moment in the film when they use that music. It's very emotive. Another of Gravenhurst's songs appeared in Meadows' 2004 British psychological thriller Dead Man's Shoes. Also appearing in the film, but not on the soundtrack, was Chinese Water Python, an instrumental from the 1990 album I by the peerless and prolific English singer-songwriter Robin Hitchcock.
See, now I plummet, search for the source, of course. I reach the summit of Sinai to find my soul was far from it. Duck to water, tuck to the spirit. Lamb to slaughter, spirit to me with it. Dive to the bottom to inhibit my limit. To find your sense of pride is a one-way ticket, listen.
Overtaking the competition, I'm not mistaken, I'm just born different. If I'm drowning, that's my decision.
No help for the helpless and willfully ignorant. Well, that's the thing about sin. It only counts when the good kicks in. So dance for your daddy and scream for the Grammys and dream as your boat comes in. Lewes light only light a sea. Illuminates without originate from above. Found my body in the sediment. I know a body disembodied from my sentiments. Rock bottom what it took to see my betterment. It's my problem, shit my ego to the river bed. I am his dead, I am his a crutch. I am his pride, envy, wrath, greed and gluttony. I am his fighting love, but your lowest priority. Into your mind, be formless, shapeless. Only then can you be molded to greatness. Past my prime, forgive my lateness. To these eyes, time lies, now I know my place is.
sound all around, I can see them in the crowd crying out for a reason to leave the shore, the law of the seasons. Still not sure if they're living or dreaming.
Bound by the shackles of social obligations that surround the tabernacle of capitalist expectations.
Bound by superstition, prohibition, founded in fables, limiting profound oppression, death and death on the table.
Bound by addiction, predictions of our failures.
Bound by the inscriptions of dead owners and saviors.
Bound to Russell Brothers, whichever book you read from, but whichever pool you swallow.
Whichever Arnold, Barbara, Gandhi, to Harley, Marx, Bam, Madame, Malcolm X, to Jay-Z, Bob, Berkeley, Obama, and Marlon, to Bruce Lee.
Be warm, my friend, be free, I'm all right.
Oh, Hannah, is that time? I think we better just finish the show now. Anyway, I'll be going.
Nick.
Yes, Peppers.
Now.
Oopsie.
This wouldn't get through Hannah's Could It Be Folk, would it?
Well, maybe you're just not brave enough to put that forward,
Unbelievable.
Hannah.
Unbelievable. You're like one of those terrible judges, you know, they're like casting judgment on people, going, oh, you know, you've been drinking and driving, or you know, you've done this, you've done that, and then they go out and they're found, you know, by some tabloid paper, you know, with an orange in their mouth, like, you know, and sort of six ladies around them doing terrible, questionable things after they've just sent someone down for being, you know, immodest or something, aren't you? You're like one of them, aren't you? And then you did all that, and then you get in your big Jaguar and drive home after consuming like three bottles of brandy. That's the sort of judge you are. Unbelievable.
Chinese Water Python by Robin Hitchcock.
Nick, can I just ask there? Because it's been bothering me.
Yes.
Is a Chinese water python an actual thing? Or is it a euphemism?
Oh, you mean, is it from myth, like the one-eyed trouser snake?
Yes.
The blue-veined piccolo? Or the one-string banjo?
Absolutely, that's what I'm thinking. It sounds like it belongs in that group.
Followed by Waterbound by Birmingham-based contemporary folk band The Urban Folk Quartet, featuring Josh Wunderlich. The Urban Folk Quartet consists of violinist, guitarist and mandolin player Joe Broughton, banjoist, guitarist and singer Dan Walsh, percussionist and singer Tom Chapman, and Broughton's co-founder, violinist and singer Paloma Trigas. At the time of the quartet's founding, Trigas was touring with one of Spain's most recognisable musicians and fellow Galician, the piper Carlos Nunez. Whilst Nunez has explored numerous influences over the years, in his last single, it is clear how much northern Spain is a part of the Celtic world, with strong ties to both Scotland and Ireland coming through in the tune. From 2022, this is Danza de Espadas.
We end today's show in honour of Simon Emerson, record producer, composer, guitarist, and founder of both the Afro-Celt sound system and the Imagined Village, who died earlier this month. A giant in world and roots music, Emerson was innovative and genre-defying. As his friend of 30 years, Peter Gabriel, said, "Looking back from when I first met him, I can see so many ways in which his aspirations, musicality and determination have touched all of us, changed things for the better and made our lives richer." With Peter Gabriel on vocals, here is Simon Emerson and the Afro-Celt sound system with possibly their biggest hit, "When You're Falling." Until next time, goodbye.
Goodbye.
can tell which way is down. And when you're screaming, somehow I don't hear sound.
Radio Lewes.
Local.
Community. Webcasting.